Hey, Mama made it. For those of you that don't know, my name is Ban Nicolaou. You're in the chair with the barber. This is my podcast intro episode. When I was 16, I just left school and I was obviously working in the family business, being Cypriot. We're in takeaways, of course. I knew I didn't want to do education, further education. And I was trying to figure out where I was going to head in life. I didn't know what I wanted to do for a career. I ended up being very, very unhappy. It just wasn't for me. I didn't feel like I had much of a social life. And I developed alopecia on the right side of my head. You can't see it, obviously, on the camera, but when I take pictures with people, I normally stand on the left side. Luckily for me, my left side, coincidentally, my left side, I feel, is my prettier side. And because this is my podcast, I'm sitting on the left side. But yeah, the alopecia's on the right side, which I've got over, you know, but it's still there. But up into my early 20s, I was still very unhappy. And it was mainly because of work, because of my job, and I just did not feel fulfilled. Then I had actually started barbering as an apprentice when I was like 16, 17, but I never stuck with it. And then 5 years ago, I went to London and trained and qualified as a barber, came back and I felt a lot better. It was more me. But still, I was helping my parents in the shop and trying to cut hair, but working for other people, you know. I think one thing when I was working as a barber for other people was you never feel like you're being paid your worth. So there was a lot going on for me in my head, I guess. I'd never call it mental health issues, because I think that term gets thrown around a lot now. But I was definitely unhappy for a lot of years. And fast forward, 9 months ago, I opened Alpha Male Barbers. By the grace of God, you know, I've never felt better. And I'm so happy now that I'm just willing to do things like podcasts. I'm so much more confident in myself that I'm willing to take risks. One thing is that I don't care for people's opinions. I didn't before, well, so I thought, but now I really don't care for people's opinions. I'm just doing my thing, you know, I'm trying to have fun. People have told me about podcasting before. I brushed it off, but as a barber, I feel like every haircut seems to be a podcast episode with the customer. You know, we're just having conversation about general stuff. And a lot of times I thought, the conversations that I have with my customers, you've never met these people before, but you can have such interesting conversation. They don't need to be rich or famous to have great conversations with people. And I thought, well, it'd be interesting for people to hear what we talk about sometimes. I'm not going to podcast with my actual customers because people get nervous when you turn the cameras on. Yeah, so I decided I was going to podcast. I'm not expecting to make money off it. If I can, great. I'm doing it more so for my own need for entertainment and opportunity. Putting yourself on the internet, putting yourself on YouTube, opportunity can come in a massive way as well. And as I get older, that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking to push myself as far as I can. But I'm also looking to see how much opportunity I can get and take whatever I can from it. So, yeah, that's basically the reason why I'm podcasting. For those of you that don't know what a podcast is, it's just episodes online of conversations with people. So the chair's empty at the minute, but I have got a short list of guests. Before I get into that, let me tell you this struggle that I've had putting this podcast together. So it was only about two about 2 months ago, I decided that I was going to podcast. So I'd spoke to my cousin Bang Shurupa. Shout out to Bang Shurupa, because if it was not for him, I'm fucking useless when it comes to stuff like this. I can talk and I can cut hair, and I'd like to think that I can hit a few jiu-jitsu throws at a decent level. But when it comes to like technology, I'm not tech savvy at all. So this podcast would not be happening if it wasn't for my cousin. So I had to give him a shout out. So I went to him, asked him what I needed to buy equipment wise. He was like, what's your budget? I said to him, look, I'm not Joe Rogan. I don't have Joe Rogan money. So get me the best quality stuff for the cheapest price. Okay. So about £1,500 later, here I am. The only thing I didn't need to buy was a camera, because I had my Canon EOS camera, which I take pictures of my haircuts on Instagram for. And that's got a record feature. So I didn't have that. I didn't have that I needed to buy, but then I found out that it only has like 30 minutes of recording time. So we had to scrap it. I've ended up with I'm recording off a webcam now, a very expensive and high-tech webcam. I never thought I'd have to buy a webcam that expensive, but here we are. And it was tough. I mean, Ban spent hours with me over the laptops, on the phone, sorting software, sending me all these different links to things that I need to buy. I've asked him every fucking question you could think of in regards to podcasts and equipment, and this kid has had so much patience with me. I actually felt bad for him, because I thought I must be fucking busting this guy's balls. But finally, we've got here. But yeah, this is all new to me. So I've never really been in front. I've done a few like Facebook videos for my shop and stuff, but I've never actually done anything like this. I always wanted to be interviewed. Always, for years, I always thought, I wish somebody would interview me. That would be really cool. Or I'd love to have been on a podcast. I'd love to have been on the Joe Rogan podcast or something. And then I figured, nobody's probably going to ever interview or podcast me. So what's the next best thing? You do it yourself, right? So yeah, it's all new to me. I've got notes, as you can see. These are notes. And when I've got guests, I will be, I'll have these notes, because I don't want people to think that I'm not taking this seriously. It's not a case of me pressing record on the camera and then I just wing it when I'm in front of it. I'm actually doing research into my guests, and making sure I've got notes. So I've got follow-up questions as things that I want to mention within that discussion. And I do want to make it entertaining enough for people to want to watch. Like I said, obviously you would have found out if you've been watching from the start, I do swear in my Facebook videos that I was doing for the business, and some of them were directed to like giving advice to kids when they're leaving school and stuff. I didn't actually swear, but you're going to get the real, not like it was the fake me, but it was more of the professional me. And I wouldn't say this is unprofessional, but for podcasts, you're going to get the real, raw, uncut version of me. And I do swear a lot. If you're offended, I apologize. Sorry, not sorry. And so here's the process that I'm planning with this. So I'm planning to have it on things like Spotify, but also on YouTube. So the way that Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, so that them kind of social media platforms works is that you have to be consistent with how much you post. So it's run off algorithms. So the more you post, the more chance you've got of people seeing it. So if I recorded one today and one in 5 weeks' time, it's not really going to show up much. So the plan is, I'm going to try and record between 7 and 9 episodes. have them fully edited as much as I need doing, and then start releasing them like once every 2 weeks. If I've got 9 episodes done and I release one every 2 weeks, that gives me 18 weeks head start, and in that time I can record another one hopefully, and then that puts me in front. So I do have a short list of guests. They're not all definites yet. I'm hoping by the time, if they all turn out to be definites, I'm hoping I've got about 9 episodes sorted. But none of them will be released until I've done all of them. So probably after summer, you might be looking at September, October before I actually start releasing them. I am very impatient. I would like to get them out earlier, but timing is key. And also I'm going to be back in Cyprus for 2.5 weeks in August, so that puts a delay on things. The guests that I've got and the guests that I'm planning to have, I want a variety of stuff. I'm a barber, we're in a barber shop. There will be some barber related things because I'm in the industry, but it's not all going to be barber related. I want interesting people or interesting subjects. Some are going to be informative, some are going to be a bit more informal, more of a conversation and a laugh. But I want something for everybody. The shortlist, I'm not going to really give away what I've got guest wise at the minute, but there is going to be a variety of things. What I will ask, which I'm asking you all now, is if anybody knows anybody worth having on the podcast, please send them my way and I can do my research and hopefully I can get them on here. A lot of people are saying to me like, oh, I'll be on the podcast. Here's the question that you need to ask yourself. Are you worth being viewed by people that don't know you? Because the people that know you are going to want to watch you on the podcast, maybe, so you'd hope, but not everybody will. And I'm not saying I'm the most entertaining guy and everyone's going to watch me, but I'm the host and the attention is more on the guest than it is on me. And also it's my podcast, so like I said, if no one's going to put you on one, you just do it yourself. So don't get offended if I tell you I don't want you on my podcast. But it's got to be entertaining for the viewers. And I have to be entertained as well, you know. I want people that have some expertise in different areas or a lot of knowledge, or they themselves have got a really interesting story. And I want to speak to them people. If someone's got expertise in a certain field, even though I can respect that, if I'm not that entertained by it, we're not going to get the best podcast. So if you know anybody or you yourself feel that you've got a very interesting story or we can talk about something interesting, send me a message via Instagram or Facebook and let me know and I'll look into it and we can sort it out. Again, you will be on, if I do decide to have this person on, whoever it is, you will be on the list. So it won't be like a straight away thing, but I will definitely look into it because I'm going to need as many guests as I can get. I'm not famous yet, so it's a bit harder for me to get guests. I will hopefully get some big names in or bigger names. No disrespect to the people that I've actually got lined up, but people that a lot more people know, I'm hoping I can get that, you know, with by next year, I'm hoping. There's people I've got my eye on that I'd like on the show. I don't know whether I can get them. I probably can't get them yet, but hopefully when this takes off, I will be able to. But still, I'm you don't have to be famous to be on the podcast. I love having conversations with all sorts of people. That's why I love my job. Being a barber, I talk to so many different people and have great conversations. So if it's entertaining enough, we can do it. But apart from that, guys, that's all I've got for now. I'm looking forward to this a lot more than people think. And I really, really do appreciate the support that everybody's given me. I'm getting so much support when people see me, people in the barbershop, Instagram, that kind of stuff. Loads of support about people looking forward to this. So I hope you enjoy it as much as I'm going to enjoy it. And stay tuned, and you'll see me soon. Yeah.